Hi everybody, Joel Colander here again for Rock Island Auction Company. Thanks for tuning in for another set of videos for our December 2018 Premier Firearms Auction, which is actually November 30th, December 1st, and 2nd of this year. With me today, Seth Isaacson, one of our describers who has an affinity for antique arms. Now Seth, antique arms don't get a lot of the credit and attention that they deserve for their place in history, especially relative to, say, the Colts and Winchesters, the U.S. and German arms of World War II. Tell me about this gun and why it's so fantastic.
So, one thing that's so cool about this gun is that it exists at all. So what you were just saying leads right into that. Very few guns from prior to the American Revolution still exist, let alone in solid condition. And this gun's all here. So what's really cool about this gun is we know it was made prior to the Revolution, based on it being dated 1758.
We have a little escutcheon on the grip there.
There's a silver thumb plate right here. It just says 1758. And it's also dated up on the barrel here. It says made October, and then it kind of fades out, but obviously 1758. And we also know several other guns by this particular maker were made that year. So it was made by Medad Hills. His family, which is his father, himself, and his brother, all made guns, and they actually signed their guns on the butt plate, right here on the butt plate tang, which is kind of unusual. You know, a lot of times we think of American arms, they're usually signed on the barrel, but they actually signed theirs right here. It says Medad Hills. And then he also, like his father, so right here on the side plate, it's actually marked made for Isaac Hill. So that's pretty unusual, and it's a silver side plate, which is pretty cool. So we know exactly who the gun was made for, which is pretty unusual from that time period. A lot of guns are pretty plain and unmarked from that time period. But now we know exactly who the gun was made for, and based on the date, we can also figure out when it was used.
That's fascinating. I know just from my limited experience with Kentucky rifles, a lot of those come to us unmarked with any maker whatsoever. Mm-hmm. So to not only have the maker, but be able to trace it to a family of makers, to have it who it was presented to or made for, and to have that engraved on a silver side plate, that's all pretty exciting from a historical perspective.
Yeah, so it's absolutely incredible. You don't see pieces like this. So the gun is, both Medad Hills and Isaac Hill are from Goshen, Connecticut. And they both served in Connecticut units. Isaac Hill actually fought in the French and Indian War, which is pretty awesome, and the American Revolution. Medad Hill, during the French and Indian War, was busy making guns, so he wasn't fighting. But he did serve in the Connecticut militia after the French and Indian War and into the American Revolution. So we have two guys that fought for, you know, the United States, effectively, in two of the most important conflicts of the 18th century.
He may not have fought, you know, on a front line or on a battlefield, but I can't imagine there were a whole lot of manufacturers constructing firearms for the military at that time in early America.
Mm-hmm. And this gun was probably, given that it was built during the war, he may have built it specifically as a fusil for the militia, but it also may have been cut back just a little bit from here, from being a fouling piece, so a longer, you know, gun for hunting birds.
Sure, make do with what you have.
And you can kind of see there's a little bit of a trace right here of a bayonet lug. So it was obviously designed to take a bayonet for being used in service.
So we had a bayonet lug up here. Tell me about some more of the features of the gun that come down here. I notice these large, distinct, what appear to be brass inlays in the barrel.
Yeah, it's got some brass bands right here. The side ones are just kind of decorative, and they got a little bit of, you kind of see some really light engraving on them. And then up here, it actually says the date that it was made. It's made October, the rest of it's kind of faded out. Mm-hmm. But we know from other guns by Medad Hills that he'd put the actual full date the gun was made for the individual on the side plate on the top of the barrel, which is pretty cool. So now we know exactly when a gun was made. It just doesn't happen very often. Some other characteristics on the gun, if you flip it over, this engraving on the lock is also very similar to other Medad Hills guns. And you can see the stock itself is fairly plain. There's not any carving or decoration in it, but it's actually a really nice piece of curly maple. It's got some really nice flame figure on it, so that's something collectors of early American firearms really like to see. And we've even got a little bit of engraving down here on the trigger guard. You can kind of see some kind of early American, little simpler style construction. We've got like a staple basically holding the front. You got a little nail here. There's no trigger plate, which is something you'd probably find on like a European-made gun, but an American-made gun, they kind of left things a little simpler sometimes.
It's a beautiful piece of wood.
Yeah, it's a gorgeous gun.
Beautiful brass. It really represents a lot of the early construction that was used by a fledgling nation that didn't certainly have the industrial capabilities of its brethren across the sea.
Absolutely, and it's in, as we've said before already, it's in remarkable shape. I mean, even with Kentucky rifles that are made in the early 19th century, you generally find them, they've got cracks and they're banged up. Mm-hmm. And this gun was presumably used in both the French and Indian War and the American Revolution. And it's got some signs of being used for sure. It's got some little dings and stuff that you'd expect to see on a gun that, you know, was carried into battle, but it's in remarkable shape.
That you would want to see on the gun.
Yeah.
That is purported to be in two of the largest like watershed battles of the 18th century.
Absolutely.
So between the gorgeous maple stock, these brass inlays, the escutcheon on the grip, the engraving, and the fact that it exists at all, it's in just outstanding condition and a really handsome piece of Americana. And it's my understanding that to even have pieces of these guns will sell for quite a handsome price.
Yeah, one of Medad Hill's guns, like basically this portion back, mm-hmm. no lock, none of the you know, important bits of a gun were left, just the stock, and it sold for five figures.
My goodness. And here we have a whole...
Yeah, we got a whole gun.
And here we have the whole gun.
And we know it was used, presumably, in the American Revolution and back in the French and Indian War. So easily the most important, you know, military conflicts of the 18th century in terms of American history, and some would argue in terms of American history, period.
An American artifact, fantastic history. Obviously, we're going to come back for more videos with Seth to show you the variety that's in the December 2018 Premier Firearms Auction. You can see this gun, pick more close-up pictures on our website, rockislandauction.com. So tune in, subscribe for more videos. Mark those auction dates to your calendar, November 30th, December 1st, and December 2nd.